Welcome to Higher Study Prep. Today, we are going to discuss some easy strategies on how to solve data interpretation problem and then show one easy example so you can practice. So in GRE test, we are always in a time crunch and we have very limited time to solve a problem. So it's always better to practice more and know the formats of the tests that are going to come. And especially for data interpretation, since we are using some other formats of maths, it's always good to practice the arithmetic and general type of math before even practicing the data interpretation. Because as you will practice, you will see that most data interpretation involve ratios, percentage, those kind of maths. So practice the other kinds before practicing the data interpretation. The second tip that I would say is that try the different formats of data interpretation problems, because they come in different shapes and forms. You can see data interpretation in the form of table, bar graphs, overlay plots, pie charts, and so many other formats. So practice as much as possible to see that how data can be presented in different formats. And the third tip that I would give is that don't get overwhelmed, because in most questions, there will be a lot of information and most of which are not even pertinent. So try to look at the data and see which information is relevant to the question and try focusing on that. And today when we are going to show an example, all these points will become clear to you. So let's proceed to the question and see how we can solve a data interpretation problem. So at a first glance, you can see that it's a table format and there's a lot of data. But as I said, don't get overwhelmed. So what I will do is that I will quickly glance at the question first to see what information is relevant. So here it says, how much in USD did company 1 generate from selling chemical B in 2001? So here's my first pointer. They're only focusing on chemical B and 2001. So as you can see here, there are two sections of the table, the year 2001 and 2002. So from the first section, it's apparent that we will be focusing only on the year 2001. So no need to look at the other side of the table. So I'm getting back into the question and reading it again. How much in USD did company 1 generate from selling chemical B in 2001? Assuming all of 6 companies accounted for an equal share of total amount of chemicals sold that year. So there are some keywords that I'm focusing, as you can see. So here you can see company 1 and chemical B in 2001. So here for the year 2001, there's chemical B and I can see that company A. So probably these are some of the data I'll be looking into. And then as they say that how much USD, so what's the money that company 1 earned in year 2001 from chemical B alone? But they're also assuming that all the other 6 companies, that is company 1 to 6, they made an equal share of total amount of chemical sold that year. So we're still talking about chemical B. So instead of looking at here, I'll be looking at here where it shows the total amount of chemical sold by all the 6 companies. So since they are having an equal share, so I can divide this amount, which is in a million liter, by 6 to get that equal share, which is equal to 3,812 million liters. So I have the amount of chemical B sold by each company. And now I proceed to the specific question, which is how much USD did company 1 generate from selling chemical B in 2001? So if you look into the data here for chemical B, this amount corresponds to the unit of cents per liter. You always have to be careful about the unit therein. So in order to find the amount of money that company 1 generated, we have to multiply this unit price, which is 108.9 cent per liter, with the amount that was sold this year for each chemical, which is 3,812 million liters, based on the assumptions that all companies have equal share of chemical being sold. So be careful that this unit is in cent, but ultimately we're looking for USD. And there's also a conversion factor here, 100 cent equal to 1 USD. So since we want this to be in USD, I'm using this conversion factor here so that we can get the final result. So here you can use a calculator and get your final result, which is 4,151 million USD. So that should be our answer. So if you notice here that there were a lot of information, but I only parsed the information that's necessary, focusing on the keywords such as which year, which chemical, which company, and also focus on the unit. So ultimately we want how much money did that company earn, and be wary of all the units that's been represented in each column. And you can also see that we did not use all the information. All we used is the unit price here and the amount of chemical here to calculate the final amount. So using examples like this, you have to practice on how to identify the useful information out of all this data and then calculate. So once you identify which information you need, you can see that the calculation is pretty simple. So go ahead and practice as much as data interpretation problems as you can, and best of luck with that. We hope that we have been able to help you with the data interpretation example. Thanks.